of the CJ on Trial. And with me here in the Senate studio is one of the prosecution panel spokespersons, Congressman Erin Tanyada.
Good afternoon,
Congressman. Good afternoon. Thank you for joining us. Later on, we'll also be joined by a member from the defense panel. But siguro unahin natin, since our defense guest is not yet here, pag-usapan muna natin, Congressman, yung nawawalang dokumento. Yesterday, there was a manifestation on the floor that a couple of two pieces of documents brought out by Mr. Demetrio Vicente, you know, the witness of the defense, has gone missing.
It's only one piece of document. This is with regard to the acknowledgement receipt issued by Mrs. Cristina Corona that she borrowed, no, or whatever. I haven't seen the exact document that she borrowed the titles from Mr. Vicente. I was informed before I came here that the document had been returned to the defense intact, just one document, and so the issue of the missing document has been already
okay.
Resolved.
That's good news. So thank you for breaking that information here. Well, just as a background to our viewers, you know, on Tuesday night after the trial adjourned, see, Mr. Vicente was here, who wanted to talk to Attorney Justiniano, JJ Justiniano, kasi nga hinahanap niya yung mga dokumento that were presented during the trial. So, ano nangyari? We were able to trace it. It was actually with the prosecution team?
Yes, the way it was explained, there were so many documents that were on the table of the prosecution team. And the head of the team, Congresswoman Marlene Agabas, then consolidated all the documents when the session adjourned, and she placed it in her car. Mm-mm. And so, as she explained yesterday, the car that she was bringing yesterday was not the same car she rode the day before. So she asked the car to come back yesterday, and they located the document and returned it to the defense.
Mm-mm. So, naiwan pala sa kotse ni Congresswoman Agabas. Which she did not use yesterday. Okay, that's good news. Let's ask you about your projections for this afternoon's hearing.
Well, based on the compliance that was submitted by the defense, we're expecting that the city assessors would be presented today. Mm-hmm. Although they can always surprise us with by bringing out different witnesses, but basically it will be the city assessors. I think the purpose of the presentation of this witnesses is to justify the entries in the statements of assets and liabilities and net worth with regard to the assessed value and fair market value of the property. So this is what we're expecting today.
Over the past 2 days, the defense has been presenting witnesses talking about the allowances and some of the income received by the Chief Justice over the past how many years. And although they have yet to explain the purpose of this presentation, what is your take on that? Why are they presenting this?
Well, our take is that they want to show that the Chief Justice had or has other sources of income to maybe to justify purchases of some real property. But in our point of view, it also strengthens our case because the question here, if he indeed uses the allowances given by these offices, the Supreme Court, the HRET, and the SET, then this amount should also be declared in the statements of assets and liabilities and net worth. Mm-hmm. The other point here is, of course, you cannot use allowances for personal use. Mm-hmm. No, that has to be distinguished. And if that is the case, then should be subject to income tax.
Oh, okay, let's bring into the discussion Attorney Karen Jimeno of the defense panel. Good afternoon, Attorney.
Yes, good afternoon, Linda. And
hindi ka naman naapektuhan ng transport strike, I'm sure.
Mas maluwag ang traffic ngayon.
Actually. Well, as we were discussing, Attorney Karen, ano, over the past 2 days, we've been people have been trying to divine what where the defense is going to by producing all these witnesses talking about the additional, let's say, additional income or sources of income on the part of the Chief Justice.
Well, this relates to Article 2 because if you remember, it's also Article 2 where the prosecution presented PIR Commissioner Henares, and they were saying, at least there was one objection at one point, that we were saying that is this related to Article 2.4? Because she seemed to be implying before that Chief Justice Corona only had fixed income that was declared, and that's it, and that's why he could not afford the properties that we were also presenting as evidence. Mm-hmm. But this addresses that point, that if they were saying that, no, this relates to Article 2.3 in declaration niya sa SALN, then we're also showing that, yes, this is also related to 2.3 declarations in the SALN, to other sources of income of Chief Justice Corona. And of course, we can't present all witnesses all at the same time. Kaya kailangan unti-unti. We're showing na ito yung iba niyang income, because some, I've been through some interviews na sinasabi rin, imposible ganun yung account siya because meron siyang ibang expenses. Ito yung pinapakita na for other expenses, he has allowances to cover them. That's why nakakaipon siya, and that's why he has also other sources of income na naiipon din, and that's why he can buy properties. And we will show eventually kung paano to dineclare sa SALN, paano dineclare yung mga properties. So we have pieces of the story, but we have to put them on the table one by one.
Mm-mm. Ang impression kasi ng mga tao is that you're trying to justify, given that he only had this as income as from his salary at the Supreme Court, and as attested to by the BIR and the Alpha List, parang ang gusto niyo patunayan, no, he has other sources of income, and therefore he can afford to buy those properties, and therefore they could not necessarily be considered ill-gotten wealth. But yung 2.4, as if we can remember, has already been rejected, ano, by the Senate.
No, that's not what we're trying to do, and we're not trying to go there. Kasi yun naman, even them, they presented, and that's why pinayagan din si BIR Commissioner Henares, because they were saying this is under Article 2.2 and Article 2, Paragraph 2.2 and 2.3. But her testimony standing alone, yun nga lang yung lumabas na fixed income, yun yung withholding tax. That's why we're addressing that point then, na hindi yan accurate, because there are other income, yung mga sources of income niya from his position that were not included in that testimony.
Just very quickly, okay, Attorney, before I turn you over to the studio, what can we expect this afternoon? Who will be your guests? Witnesses.
It's really hard to give a definite answer kasi yung sa amin, we just have a request for subpoena, and then there are some subpoenas that have been issued, and they were of course given out, but then we don't know who will turn up it, depending on yung sa subpoena. Like yesterday, biglang may dumating na witness na medyo past the trial period na nag-start na. They said they just got the subpoena around 10:55 a.m. that day, so they had to prepare suddenly and to come here. So hindi namin alam na kung may mga witnesses na ganun din kabilis mag-react that they can be here. So it's hard to say na this and this person, tapos baka mamaya hindi lumabas doon. Kaya I don't want to commit to saying kung sino.
Okay. Well, Karen and Adele, our guests this afternoon.
All right, I'll start with Congressman Tanyada. Congressman, good morning. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Karen and Adele.
Okay. All right. Yesterday, Senator Chi said a very good point. Ang tanong niya, una ito, sa simpleng salita, ano na ba ang napatunayan ng prosecution na kailangan depensahan ng depensa pagdating sa SALN? So when it comes to the properties, the Chief Justice admitted to 5. How many are we talking about na kailangan niyang ipaliwanag kung ba't hindi niya dineklara? Are we talking about 6 properties? Was that the final count?
Well, kung titignan po natin yung sagot po ng ating Chief Prosecutor Junjun Tupas, binanggit po niya 21.
Yun yung una.
Yes. So at different again, we should look at it at the general sense at different intervals in different years, because admittedly Chief Justice Corona mentioned that he had 5 properties and he had declared it, and if we look at it, he declared it on the SALN of 2010.
Yes.
Now we're not only talking of SALN 2010, but we're talking of SALN 2002, 2003, 2004, all the way up to 2010. So that's why the number is at that.
I wanted to ask you, why is the SALN before 2010 relevant?